There are embalmers whose skill go beyond the slowing down of decomposition. The love of their work, coupled with artistic perfection, drive and inspire them to develop techniques and invent chemical solutions that would attempt to preserve the human body from corruption and enable us to view the deceased as they had been in life. In earlier times, such skillful embalmers were very much in demand, and they were very secretive about their methods and the exact recipe of their embalming fluids. Usually these secrets would accompany them to the grave. Let's take a drive to downtown Chihuahua, Mexico. There's a certain shop there which specializes in bridal gowns. Unfortunately, we find the shop owner, Pascualita Esparza, in mourning. She had recently lost her daughter to a spider bite on her wedding day. The daughter's name has been lost to history, but we know her today as La Pascualita. There were other bridal dress stores in town, and they all had to compete with each other for business. The style and quality of gowns, plus the most realistic mannequins to model the gowns, would lure the most customers to the display windows. Further on down the street, we arrive at La Popular Bridal Shop. The shop has reopened after a respectful period following the demise of Señora Esparza's daughter. The year is 1930 and there is a brand new gown on display. But what startles the passers-by even more is the new mannequin displaying the gown. What was even more disturbing to the people who stopped to stare at the lifelike figure in the window was how uncanny the hands looked on the dummy. It was almost like blood was still flowing through them. Some of the curious made the sign of the cross at seeing the fingernails and wrinkles, which even the best wax modeler could surely never create. Some less brave souls fled the scene upon gazing up at the face of the mannequin. It was the eyes. They seemed to gaze directly at you and followed you when you moved. All who dared to look into her eyes had the strong impression that they were being watched in return. Rumor quickly began to spread that the mannequin closely resembled the Señora's late daughter. Some scoffed at the idea, but for others the likeness was too real. Had Señora Esparza paid for the services of an expert embalmer? The accusations become numerous, and Señora Esparza received abusive letters and telephone calls. Eventually, she issued a public statement through a notary, refuting the claims. But it was too late. The legend became set in stone. Throughout the decades, tales spread that the mannequin moved at night. Workers felt uneasy being the last one in the shop in the evening. Others refused to change her outfits. One shop worker, Sonia Bertsiaga, said, "Her hands are very realistic and she even has varicose veins on her legs. I believe she's a real person." To this very day, La Pascualita can be seen serenely greeting people who stop to pay homage to her. The staff always dress her behind heavy curtains to preserve her modesty, and she is always attired in a classic bridal outfit, befitting her age and dignity. Needless to say, the occupants of the flat above the small bridal gown shop in Chihuahua have never ventured downstairs in the middle of the night. Well, most have never done so. Well, my dear friends, I will give you a few moments to recover yourselves, to recover your composure, and to clean up any spilt beverages over yourself or over the computer or laptop. Regulars who have been here for a while and have already seen the silent version of this that I made in 2016, as you can see by the end screen, the date, will have been ready for the shock ending, but newcomers will probably be somewhat surprised, as that's not my usual video format. So if you've watched just a few previous historical features, you may not have expected that. I do apologize for anyone who has had a great shock. I don't sort of do those endings anymore. This was, sort of early days of the historical features, and so I do hope you forgive me for any heart palpitations or clothes that need to be taken to the laundry. And by the way, I normally like to have a go at doing an accent, trying to emulate accents from different parts of the world, but I didn't try with the Mexican accent. I admit that's probably not one of my stronger accents. I may have to listen to some old Cheech and Chong albums to get that one down pat. Yes, I would just like to address a problem that I've not only been hearing about from my viewers, but also other creators have mentioned this quite a few times. It's not a new problem, it's been around for a while, and that is to do with subscribing and subscriptions. It appears that there's some glitch where if you subscribe to a channel, you may find yourself unsubscribed and you don't even know it. So you're wondering why you're not getting notifications of new uploads. It's because you're no longer subscribed, or your subscription notification settings have been changed, unbeknownst to you. So, just for anyone who doesn't know about subscribing, I'm going to use as an example Madeline Swan's channel. Hello, Maddie. How are you? Thank you for letting me use your channel as an example. And please go and check Madeline's channel out. She has some fun stuff happening over there. Tells some great stories. And so as you can see here, I'm going to just unsubscribe Madeline. Please excuse me. It won't be for long. Just so I can show my viewers how this is done. And then I will resubscribe. So once we subscribe, you can see to the right of that, you will see a bell symbol. So if you want to be notified about any new uploads I do, you have to click on that bell symbol and then check the box, send notifications. And then you will receive notifications when I make a new upload, when I post a new upload. And I would advise all of my viewers just to check to see if they're still subscribed to me. As I say, this is a problem. YouTube is aware of this. I actually wrote to them about half a year ago about this, and they said they are aware of the problem and they're working on it, but it still seems to be happening. And also, any subscribers who are still subscribed, just check your notification settings to make sure that you're still checked to get notifications, all of them. Yes, I had a few comments from my viewers over the last few days saying that they hadn't received notification of any new uploads, and they'd just come along to my channel to see whether I had any new uploads, and there they had realized that they weren't being notified and that some of them were actually unsubscribed. They hadn't done it, it just happened. So please, YouTube, please get your act together. You're making it difficult. Yes, we shall just soldier on, my dear Oddites. We shall soldier on in the face of adversity. I will now be accepting designs for the upcoming t-shirt competition that I haven't yet sort of organized and haven't really thought about how it's going to work, but it's going to happen. So I will put my email address on the screen. You can send your designs there. What I'm going to do is I will get the designs together, all the images, and I will let the viewers vote and decide which ones they like the best. And I'll organize a prize for first, second, and third winners. So, yeah, I will repeat this message on a new historical feature in case some of the regulars are not watching this older version that's been re-edited with narration. So, anyway, love to see your designs. As I mentioned in a previous video, I probably won't be able to reply to you, but I will check your designs out and I will sort of collate them together for the upcoming competition. And on that note, I think I have indeed rambled enough. And so I will wish you a good night or good morning or good day to wherever you are in the world. Let me know your ideas. I'm always open to feedback, as you know. Love to hear what you've got to say. Please share. And I will also be opening a new social account very, very soon. And I will notify you all when I have done that. I'm just so busy at the moment. Oh my God, I can barely think. It's so much going on. I'm a one-man band here doing it all myself, so it's rather difficult. Anyway, my friends, good night, good day. God bless.